Hi there, I'm Ben, and welcome to part 18 of my full Platinum walkthrough for Dark Souls 2, Scholar of the First Sin. Memories, that's what this one's called, and that's what we're going to do. We're going to go and do four different memories. Three of which we need to do, one of which I'll just show you because it's really cool. And you can get a boss soul from there, essentially. So, we're going to go back to the Forest of Fallen Giants, and they are all there, apart from the final one that you don't need to do. So, the idea is we're going to go to see some fallen giants and go into their memories and go and get some giant souls, which are going to make Vendrick, a boss, a side optional boss, easier, along with a key kind of thing. It's still just a soul to actually finish the game with. We are able to go to the end point of the game, but to actually finish the game, you just need this boss soul. So I'm going to go and do both. Let's just think of it. There's two side memories and then there's one main sort of boss memory. So this is one of the side memories. So you'll probably remember where we are. You've been here several times probably, or definitely early on you were here. And you'll remember this giant just lying here. So if you interact with it at this point, now that we have the mist heart that we got from the ancient dragon, we can go into the memories. This one is the memory of Vanmar. There's Oro, Jay, and then there's a dragon memory as well. So go down here. I'm going to speak to this guy for two reasons. One, we're going to get the final gesture from him and finally get the gesture trophy. Again, if you don't have them, by the time this guide is finished, there will be a list on my website. There'll be a link in the description as well to the website of all gestures and everything that we need to collect, pyromancies and everything like that. So you should have it at this point now. If the website is not up, leave a message, I'll try and help you out and figure out which one you've not got. Yeah, so these are giants. Basically, we've gone back in a memory and we are back with the war. The giants versus the humans kind of thing. You can actually backstab a giant, this one at least. That's what I was trying to circle and trying to show you. You can actually backstab them, which I thought was kind of weird. But you can. And we're just going to speed run through this memory. So all we've come here to do was to speak to that guy, get the gesture, fully exhaust his dialogue to get that gesture. And then we're going to run through and we're going to get the soul of a giant, which is going to make Vendrick easier towards the end of this video. We're going to go and do Vendrick's boss fight. We've already seen him. He's just kind of wandering around at this point. But we're just going to make him easier. It's definitely not a good idea to take him on at this point. So we're just going to run through, let the humans and the giants fight by themselves, fight amongst themselves, and try and land on his head, run to the end. We only need to go and pick a certain something up, so that's what I'm going to do. There is a petrified something here if you want that. I'm not going to be using it, but it can obviously help you along the way if you go and cash it in. And we'll run down here and go up here, and this is the only giant you actually need to fight, really. You don't even need to fight this one, you could just go straight for the item if you wanted. Like, you can run past most of them, even the first one I fought. This one, you will recognise the fighting style, it's the giants that we fought in the dark area, in the Black Gulch. Exactly the same. They do look smaller when they're out in the light here though. So grab this, and then most importantly the soul of the giant here. This is what we're after. So, once you've done that, just do examine again and you will leave the dream. Now, these dreams are timed. You can only stay in them for a certain amount. I don't know the exact time, but if you mess around too much or try and kill everything, you'll run out of time and you'll just come back to the main world here, even if you haven't got the soul of the giant, which is what we went for. So, yeah, the best thing to do is just speed run through them. There's nothing worth seeing apart from them, really. Yeah, so that's one down. Now we're going to go and do the other side one and fully exhaust Ben Hart. So Ben Hart is there. We're going to get his trophy in this video. A few trophies in this video, actually. Exhaust Ben Hart's dialogue. Make sure he's available for the final fight in the final dream to make sure we get his trophy. So again, it is still here, just in the Forest of Fallen Giants. The second one we're going to is behind the Pursuer's boss fight where we fought him. So I'm just going to quickly run up there. I don't know what it is. If I see an enemy, I have to kill it. I know it's really not the best for a video like this, but I can't just run past. When he's directly in front of me like that, I have to. Like those two I did run past, I should have just killed them, to be honest, while I was in front of them. or you can just run for it. But it's also very, very satisfying to slice these guys up with one hit. Well, two for this one. So here we are, this is the Pursuer, you'll remember this. And then we're going to go through, and there is another fallen giant up there. And we're just going to do exactly the same thing. We're going to go in, we're going to speak to the NPC, which is Ben Hart this time. Ben Hart will be, should be, here as well. Fully exhaust his dialogue here. First, he's going to basically pledge his sword to you, which is good. So we can use him in the boss fight later. We'll just go in here and get the soul. We will need to revisit each of these two side memories. This is the memory of Oro. We're going to revisit both of them to get the respective trophy. So we will need to come here again and speak to Ben Hart to get his trophy. And then go back to the other one and speak to Drummond to get his trophy. So yeah, I'm just going to run down here. This is the way you could kind of just run all the way to the back and get the soul. But we're not going to do that. I'm just going to quickly show you. There is a few things up here. And kind of an easier way, so you don't have to run through the melee of the big fight. So there's nothing down. No, wrong way. There you go. So yeah, I wasn't actually expecting these guys to hit so hard. I did not realize. Like, it doesn't look like much, but compared to how hard these guys hit in the normal world at this point, I was not expecting them to hit so hard. Not even marked that. That's a fading soul. You'll notice it wasn't in the top corner. That's like 50 souls. I mean, who the hell cares at the moment with those? Yeah, I'll show you this. The forest lock here. There is another one here. I always get this mixed up. I don't actually pick up the second item. There is an illusionary wall to the right. Instead of actually putting this in here, I don't know what it does. I do this every time. Yeah. Don't bother doing this. It's actually, you just, the wall on the right hand side there. There's going to be another one. I think it's an armor set. Whatever it is, we don't need it. It's fine. Yeah, I'm looking around, confusing myself again. Never mind. Right. Let's get on what we're actually here for. And that's to get the soul. Check for corners for items. You have to do that. So yeah, just ignore everyone again. Don't need to fight them. So drop down here. Down here, you can see the giant down in the bottom corner there. Onto the roof. And then go and get the soul of the giant. And we'll get the hell out of here and move on to the final one. So I'm going to just run back. I could use the feather, the age feather, to go back. But before that, I'm just going to go to a side area and grab one of the keys for the DLC. Each DLC has a key that you need to enter it. And we'll just go and get the final one. We have the other two already. We've just casually picked them up. You probably haven't even noticed. I did mention them at the time. But we have both the others. They were kind of along the way. This one's not. It's not somewhere you would necessarily go. The fire pit. So if you remember where we got that fire sword very early on when we first came here. Yeah, it's there where fire salamanders are. And we can go down there and go and just grab that now. Yeah, I definitely don't need hollow soldier leggings, that's for sure. So I'm going to go back to where the first ever boss fight was. The last giant. Which, technically, he is the last giant. We have been fighting giants, but they have been in memories. Well, technically, he wasn't the last giant, was he? There was two in Black Gulch. So it was a lie. And through this door here. And it's going to open up into a big fire area. And there's just two enemies. Don't worry, you won't take damage from the fire. It's these big salamanders that are the problem. You might recognize, if you've played Bloodborne, the sort of attack it does. Similar to those sharks looking things from the DLC in Bloodborne. In the fishing village. Very, very annoying these things are. The reason I'm not just going for it is I don't want to leave myself open. And you're going to notice there in the back, there is a second one off to the left-hand side, and you kind of want to draw this one over this way so the second one can't do what it's doing right now and fire the fireballs at you. They're the thing that hurt the most. What you want to do is try and get to the side and get stuck in between their legs. If you can do that, you should be okay, and they don't really do much damage to you. But it's just getting to that point. You don't want to be in front, and you don't want the other one firing at you. So try and drag him out of the way. They're just infuriating these. They just knock you over all the time. Right, let's get rid of this first one. And then we'll go and do the second one. If you're wondering what's up this hill, it leads to the other fire pit. We don't need to go up there. We don't, we really don't. So I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to get rid of this one. Hopefully a bit quicker than the first one. So yeah, it's that dive there. I'm sure you'll have fond memories of the enemy that does that in Bloodborne, if you've done that before. Or if you haven't and you're doing it in the future, good luck with that. Yeah, just go for it. If there's just one, you can just kind of go for it and just try and get the damage in. There, you see him kind of just stuck between his legs. Right, so from the door, if you go to the far right where the second one was, you're going to find the heavy iron key. And that is the key to one of the DLCs. So it is DLC time next. We're almost done with the main full game. We do have another covenant to do, where we're going to go to some darker areas and then eventually lead to quite a difficult boss fight. But again, I'm going to do that just before we do the final cleanup video of playthrough one. I'm going to do the DLC next, because it's not too difficult. Well, two of them aren't, that's for sure. One of them is. But we'll try and make it as easy as possible. Right, so I'm just going up here to refresh, to fix my weapon, get the durability up. Get rid of the degradation. And now we'll go and do the final one, which is where the Giant Lord is, and we'll take on him and get the Giant's Kinship, which basically allows you to finish the game. So we've been down here already. This is where the Chloranthi Ring was originally. There's going to be this knight on the right, left-hand side here. I'm sure he's probably killed plenty of these guys by now. Can't get... There we go. Nope. Yep, there we go. Find the sweet spot. And then, of course, you need to put the ring on. Same kind of door. Put the king's ring on. Only for a second, just to get the door moving. There we go. And then the final giant. There's actually a bonfire in here as well. So I didn't really need to sit at that other one, did I? I will definitely say make a backup save. Once we've stood in front of the giant's body, make a backup save. You need Ben Hart to survive the boss fight. He should do no problem. But you, just in case anything goes wrong, just make a backup save. So do that now. And then we'll go in and do this final one. So you'll notice both summon signs are here when you enter the dream, the memory. You'll find Drummond, which is this one on the right. We do not want him, so don't bring him in, because it'll get rid of Ben Hart's. Go down the stairs here and get Ben Hart's. If it's not here, it's because you've not fully talked to him in the previous memory. But this is a very easy fight, the Giant Lord. So easy, actually take it for granted, and you're going to see in a moment. So yeah, make sure he's following you. There is quite a long run up. There's basically a battle in front of you. You've got to go through, which I think is really, really cool, actually. One of the best parts of the game, the fact that you just got the giants fighting the humans, and I'm stood too close to that. I was looking up at the sky thinking, where's it gone? It's because I was too close to it. So there's going to be this constant bombardment. You're going to see them coming in from the sky. You got that one and that one, so wait for them and run. Just run past the giants, ignore the fight, look out for the head. You're going to see a head there. You can see it starting to roll on the far end there. If you hold up at the side, it will miss you. It'll kill that giant that was trying to get me, so we'll get him afterwards. Make sure we're clear and then run for it. This is the Giant Lord. Don't worry about Ben Hart, he should follow you. Just yeah, concentrate on this. So it's basically like the other giant fight, apart from he has a sword. So he does the stamping, So I'll switch to the other leg and just go for that. And then he does this swipe backwards here. You can see it there. And then he swipes forward. So it's kind of a double-edged sword. Double-edged sword attack. Yeah, so you want to stick to his left leg if you can. Because his swipe should miss on the draw back. And then you'll just kind of have to move around, get a feel for it. And this was close. I was luckily holding up. That was too close. See what I mean about taking it for granted? Apart from that, it's a very easy fight. But just watch out for the sword as he draws it back. And then it's just stamping. Yeah, and that's it. We're going to finish him now. Very simple. So as long as Ben Hart survives, that is three boss fights that he has survived with us. So we can go and get his trophy now. And we have the Giant Lord boss and the Giant's kinship, which means we can now literally go and finish the game. But we're not going to. We've got so much other stuff to do. I'm just going to run over here. There's a Fire Seed, which we just got, and then the old Radiant Life Gem. And I'm just going to go and see what this is over here. Anything of interest? It is a random drop. And of course, it's useless. One final soul of a giant to get. So we have four now. We've got one from the other two previous memories. Then we've got this one. And then we got the one when we fought the two in Black Gulch. There was a memory, a soul there. So that makes Vendrick at his weakest now, because we're holding four of these soul of a giants. Having said that, he's still not weak. Just imagine how... how strong or how much health he would have had. You'll see, we're going to go and do that in a minute. So we're going to drop down here. I'm just going to show you there's a fragrant branch of yore if you need that for any reason. Two twinkling titanite if you need any of that. Upgrade. I could just feather here, but we're right back, so I'm just going to quickly run. I forgot it's not actually just up this ladder and up again. I've actually got to run round, so we'll just do that now. I've committed to it. But we are just going to go and run and get two trophies quickly. So, holder of the forts, you can see there, that's for getting all Drummond's equipment. That was the first guy from the memory. So we're going to go to the two side memories again. That's what we're going to do. We're just going to quickly run in there. Go into the memory, speak to the guy. So it's going to be Drummond first. Speak to the guy. He's going to give us his gear, which is just the Dranglake helm. And we'll get the trophy, which is the most important part. Then we'll feather back out. And then go and do Ben Hart's. Get his trophy and his gear. He gives you a lot more gear. And then we'll just feather out. And then we'll go and do... what do we do next after that? We'll go to the next memory. I'm even confusing myself. So much running around in this one. But it's all clean up. So you have to come and speak to him after killing the giant lord to get his gear. So that's what we're doing. Back to the first one, Vanmar. This giant will be disturbed, the one that's burst through the wall, so he will smash this door. So we're not going to carry on anyway. But speak to this guy, Drummond, and you'll get to his helm and the holder of the fort trophy. So that's all we need from him. He's done. So we can just bone out, or feather out in this instance. And then we'll go and see Ben Hart and get his trophy. And you can see at the top there how much he gives us. So we're going to get the Moonlight Greatsword. Oh, that's what the trophy is called. It's actually the Blue Moon Greatsword. And then all of his gear. So his shield, his helmet, his armor, his gauntlets and his boots. So you could become Ben Hart if you want to. I've never actually done it. Probably looks pretty cool. I'm just going to get rid of these annoying ones to start with. Even though they do all spawn back in anyway. Ooh, that was worth it. A life gem. No. I should have just run. So yeah, DLC soon. It's starting in the next videos. DLC. We're going to do the longest DLC last. We're going to do the two shorter ones. I mean, they're only shorter in the fact that we're not going to fully do them, but we need to fully do the one of them, the Iron King DLC, to get everything we need. We're going in to get sorceries, certain spells. That's what we're going in for. That is it. So once we've got them, we're just going to leave. But unfortunately, one of the I think it's a pyromancy is from the old Iron King is or the Iron King DLC is right at the end. You need to do a lot in that one, unfortunately. So we're back in the memory of Oro here. I'm going to speak to him, Ben Hart. Say that you've done well. And he's going to give you all of his gear. And you'll get the trophy, which is most important part, should I say, of course. And now I'm going to go and get a boss soul that we don't need. You don't need to do what I'm about to do. But going and getting it will give you 75,000 souls. It's only going to take you a couple of minutes. So I'll show you where it is. There's a fourth memory. So if you go back to Brightstone Cove, Teldora, back to this bonfire yet again. How many times have we been to this one? And we're going to go all the way back to the boss fight. It'll just take a couple of minutes, and we'll get there. And there's another memory, and in that memory is just a soul. Now, I have said the whole time, don't use boss souls to crush them to get souls. The main reason I've been saying that is not so you don't confuse yourself as to which ones you need to use or can use. Just put a hold on all of them, and then at the end of this playthrough, that's when you can start using them. We do need to trade some still to get certain spells from Strayed. Here's Pate's gravestone. You can offer some souls to it. If you do that, he'll come back to life for some reason. I don't know. We don't need him anyway, so it doesn't matter. A more fun fact, it's voiced by Peter Serafinowicz, if you know who that is. Right, go through this door. I'm going to go and get the Southern Ritual Band plus one, which I missed the first time we were here. I don't ever need this, so I don't go and get it, really. So we'll go in this room. We've got two of the spider undead who have that annoying habit of, as they sort of die, they hit you. See there, he was already dead. And then through this door, this one would lead back to where you were eventually, to the first one. But we don't need that. We're going to use this switch behind here and bring down a chest. And you can get the Southern Ritual Band plus one, which will give you two attunement slots. It's a bit of an annoying one, this one. You just kind of need to run at it. We'll give you two attunement slots. So if you need to use spells and you don't want to buy or put points into attunement, then you can just put this ring on and you get yourself a couple of slots. I'm not going to use spells myself, but they're there if you need them. And now we'll just go to the end and get to this ancient dragon. So it's actually a really cool area. Most players will probably miss this because it is so kind of random, and you don't need to come here at all. There's no reason to come here apart from the soul. There's nothing else there. You don't need to come down here again necessarily, so you'd just miss this altogether. Yep, you'll remember this spider room, I'm sure. And you'll see how good this weapon is at crowd control. Oh, I love it. Right. Not very good in enclosed spaces, though, so we're going to use the R2 on this one. And then we're going to quickly go up here and then drop down to the boss room and enter the final dream. So yeah, there is a boss weapon tied to this soul as well, so it's up to you if you want to get there. I will do that all at the end in the final cleanup video. I'll show you which spells we need to buy, which boss weapons you can buy, and which ones you can just crack for souls if you want them. So I'm just going to ignore all of these and then run for it. So you probably noticed this when we were here last time, but this is actually a dragon that's kind of in a spider's web, which is really cool. So if this is here now, so if you press X on it, interact with it, you're going to come back here, to here, which looks a bit like something from Mortal Shell, actually. There's an area of that looks like that, and you'll see the dragon, and that's all we're here for, is interact with the dragon's head. You're going to get the ancient dragon's soul, which is worth 75,000. So I'm just having a quick look around, because it is really cool looking, this place. But yeah, all you need to do is interact with the dragon. And then like the giants, do it again and you'll leave. And now we'll go and do the Vendrick boss fight. So just feather out of here. It'll take you back to the original bonfire, and then we'll go back. Cash in the souls that we already have. 95,000 might as well. Vendrick is an extremely boring boss. Extremely boring. And he can hit extremely hard as well. Very, very easy if you know what to do. Like, don't take him on like a boss. Don't want to do that. I put a couple in dex there. So my strength is at 50. That will stay there. We'll be okay with that. And then I put a couple in dex there, which allows us to fully use one of the bows later on, which we will need to for a couple of things. One is mainly just to hit a switch. You can use bows without... without being dexterity 11, you can still use it. You just won't use it, be able to use it properly. Like, you won't get the full power of it. We might use some poison arrows later, so just get yourself to a point where you're able to use any bow. I'll show you the stats of them later on, the ones we've got. So yeah, we're back here with the undead crypt where Vendrick is, and we're just going to run through this place as well. Down here, so this is where the undead can ring the bell. Underneath these stairs here, I killed them the first time we were here. This time I'll just run down the left hand side and just ignore everything. If you just keep running, you'll be fine. Apart from when you run out of stamina, obviously. And then just keep going, and then these knights will just back off once you get to the end of here anyway. And there's Vendrick. So he is still docile at this point. He's not going to immediately attack you. Just making sure he's going to go away. He should turn... Yeah, he's turned around. Off he goes. And make a backup save just so you don't have to do the run back, because all of a sudden Vendrick can kill you very quickly. Not unexpectedly, but if you drop your guard for a moment, he can kill you very quickly. Now, if you have some of this, the aromatic ooze, which you should have, you can put it on your weapon just to speed this process up. You don't need to, so don't worry about it. I don't use it. Basically, it coats your weapon with magic. I don't use this in any other instance, so that's why I'm using it here. So he's not hostile at this point, so just keep hitting him until he is. And then don't do this and get stuck against the wall. That was a complete mess. What you're supposed to do is keep him away from the wall at all times, really. Because you want to be circling him constantly. And if you get stuck on a wall, that's not going to help. Yeah, and just keep circling his left-hand leg. His left, your right. And just keep doing it. Once he attacks, one, two. And then keep circling. He may jump away now and again. And he does have a jump slam attack he might do sometimes. Most of the time, he'll just kind of run towards you and do some weird, lazy attack that is really slow. But you can see how much health he has. Yeah, got caught out again. You don't want to be on the left, your left, his right. He can make short work. He'll cut straight through your shield. And how little damage. Well, we're doing the same amount of damage we normally would, but how much health this guy has. Now, once you get a feel for it, you can get a bit more adventurous. And just with each attack he does, do maybe three, maybe even four attacks. Just make sure you leave yourself enough to dodge out the way. And just keep following that leg and trying to hit him. And if he does put his wall against the back like that, try and draw him back out. And you'll be fine. So this is going to take a while. But yeah, you see why I said it's so boring. I mean, even to fight him head on, it's just not viable because he hits so hard. One slip up and you're gone. It's a good... 5 or 10 minutes of concentration you'd need to do this fight legitimately, just standing in front taking one on one. But the circling this leg makes it extremely boring. So if you want the challenge, go for it. But you'll die in two hits. Yeah, you don't want to be on this side. Quickly get around him again. I mean, you could probably double hand to get that extra damage in, but I always like to have the shield up just in case. You can see I was using it then. It's just kind of a habit at this point. Rolling is probably the best option anyway, because you can get right out of the way. And then you don't drain all of your stamina as well. So if you feel confident enough, then yeah, go for the double hand and do that extra bit of damage. Speed this process up a bit. Nearly there. Couple more hits. One, two, done. And you'll get the Vendrick trophy. That is it. That's all we need from him. This is just a trophy thing. There's no other reason to kill this guy. We won't be doing it again. You don't need it for the end of the game. It's a side boss. It's nothing. This is his body here. You could come and talk to this. Well, talk to him. So I'll just show you so you know you can do it. If you want to, you go to the Memory of the King. And just speak to him. There's nothing else here. All you do is speak to him. And then if you go up the stairs, you'll leave the memory. But we'll just feather out anyway. So exhausted dialogue, speak to him. Get an idea for it. He talks about the DLC, I believe, the crowns. And then we'll go back to Majula. Now, I was going to leave the video at this point, but I will actually just show you where Vendrick's soul is. You may notice we didn't get a soul when we killed him. It is in a place that I don't like, and I'm sure you probably don't like either. But we'll just go and do that quickly. I'll show you the bow. So I was just checking. So the dexterity is the hand there. 12, 11, 16. We've got 11, so we can use the Bellkeeper bow. That's fine. So I'll just keep it at that, and we'll use that. So here I'm going to put into intelligence, weirdly enough. I never want to use the magic, no intention of using it, but what it does is get your magic defense up. I don't need points anywhere else, really, so I'm just sort of strengthening my defenses. That's all it is. So yeah, I was going to leave it, but not. We're going to go back to the Shrine of a Mana. Yeah, this place again. I'm going to get the Soul of a King. This one's worth 50,000, so it could be worth a couple of levels later on. But yeah, you have to deal with these. I will also show you a Pyromancy. I always forget about this Pyromancy because I don't get it. I get it from the dragon, the second dragon that we fought. But I'll just show you where it is. It's in a tricky little place. We do already have the Pyromancy. But for whatever reason, just in case, I'll show you where it is here as well. Try and dodge. Oh god, I hate these things. And we've got to come back here in New Game Plus as well. And it's not. The thing is you can't speed through it. You can't just run because those creatures will chase you down. You stop for a moment to just get rid of it, and these mages, these sorceress, whatever they are, they'll hit you. You have to take each guy out. Right, so you'll remember here there was a dragon rider. If you didn't kill him, he will still be here and you will need to do so. But now, because he's gone, I'm free to run across. And we can open this door up. So this door you could not open until you kill Vendrick. And inside is a chair with the Soul of a King on. So Vendrick's soul. And now we'll just quickly show you Fire Tempest, and then I promise we'll finish the video. And then the next one will be the DLC, the first DLC. Not sure which one we'll do yet. It doesn't matter. The only one we will do last definitely is the most difficult one. The one we need to fully complete. So yeah, don't aggravate him over there. We don't need to do that. Just need to come this way. Right, so we're in water now, obviously. So what you can do to help with this, because it is so far out there, is use a torch. That can help. And I will just light one. And then it'll go out straight away, because the enemies will come running at me straight away. So you can see to the right there, there's a big pile of urns. They're curse urns. I've rolled now, so my torch has gone out. Curse urns, so you don't want to go near them. Just two enemies there, so once you've killed those two, you're free. But what you can do is light a torch. If you already have the Fire Tempest, you don't need to do this. So look for the urns, and then look to the left-hand side. Now, if you've got the torch, you can see it helps you kind of not fall off. And just keep going sort of straight ahead from the hole. I'll show you where I am once I get there. If you keep going, you'll find a chest eventually. So that's where I am in comparison to sort of the urns and the other hut. Open that up, you're going to get Fire Tempest, which is a pyromancy. Already have it, but just in case you don't have it, that's where it is. Just quick show you, the urns are over there. That's where we are, so you can get a kind of feel for it. And yeah, I'm just going to feather out. No need to run back, that's all we came for. And yeah, it's going to be the end of this video. Onto the DLC. We're nearly there, nearly there. And then we can just run through the game after on New Game Plus, New Game Plus Plus especially. And get this platinum done. Right, thanks very much for watching. I'll see you on the next one.